There is a place where the lost embers go. As their light begins to fade, Ember ran because standing still made them feel helpless. The wall glistened. The painting showed embers on a sacred journey. The painting showed embers on a sacred journey. Ember felt so afraid and alone that it was a relief to find someone to talk to. Ember froze, almost too frightened to look away, when they noticed a small satchel. The satchel felt heavy. Ember looked inside. The statue shone brightly in the light. There was a symbol on the floor. Ember noticed something wrong. There was a round space where something used to fit. To Ember's delight, the golden statue slid perfectly into place. Ember left, feeling sorry for the stranger now alone in the dark. The stairway opened into a dark forest. Ember could feel fear taking over. They'd washed up alone, somewhere very unfamiliar. Ember felt like they were being watched. The foxes howled into the night. The only reply was silence. The path was blocked. The route ahead was guarded by twin statues, choked by clinging vines. As Ember approached, the flame seemed to call out. With a feeling like falling, the forest had slipped away. Ember felt lost in darkness and ruin. Caged flame stoked new hope in Ember. Hope was almost within reach. The flame spoke and Ember listened. The flame lingered ahead. Was it trying to escape? Or leading the way? Campfire flickered into life. The ghost spoke. Hope has returned to a forlorn. I will warm them until they choose to move on. Ember looked to the ghost for answers. This is a place between to travel through as your light fades. But none have passed on in a long time. The Forest King now holds us here, and those who linger will turn forlorn. Again, that word, forlorn. The forlorn are those who lost their way along the path. If you find them, send them to me and I will guide them. I am just a guide along the way to fan the flame. So many lost embers have I seen. More than I could help. Ember thought of those they loved. Those they'd left behind. There are others lost along their journey. Find them and I will guide them. Step backwards, little Ember. Look behind. Upon a small grassy cliff rests a forlorn. The door was sealed shut. Barely visible through the murky water was, and on a small pier with barely a sound, a lonely fisherman sat. The Ember was curious. But I'm headed for the crossroads. It's not far, I think. I've heard there's a nest there. A safe place. The traveler said, "You sailed in here. Where's your boat?" "Friend, you need a boat. Go see the builder in the caves. Tell them I'm sorry I never came back." The stranger had blazed their own path. Created their own rock, their own islands. They did not need Ember's kindness. But still, Ember stayed. Building a bridge, should it ever be needed. The stranger met Ember's eyes. The two shared a moment of silence. The stranger met Ember's eyes. The two shared a moment of silence. The fisherman murmured quietly between soulful breaths. The fisherman murmured quietly between soulful breaths. The fisherman felt so useless. His former joys were hollow. only the dark water to hear him talk. In that darkness, a glimmer flickered. A thought beating like a drum. A thought that went round and round. It all started with a frog. Every day by the pond, a constant reminder. For a brief moment, the fisherman struggled to speak. He looked at Embo, hopeful. The fisherman spoke softly. There's a frog in that pond, a big one. Saw him grow from a tadpole. We were friends of a sort, spent every day side by side. So much better at fishing than me, that frog is. Catches them before I can bait them. Oh, it makes me feel useless some days. The fisherman sighed. I've wasted so much time feeling like this. The old man looked carefully at the pond, at their rod, at Ember. Well, listen to me here, rambling on and on. It helps, though, telling someone. Thank you, Ember. If you need help catching anything, you just ask. You saw the frog? Did the frog mention me? You ask the frog about me, see what they say. Actually, no, just... Please don't tell the frog how much I talk about them. They say catching a fish isn't the point. So I tell myself that. I tell myself that a lot. I chased old Blue Betty round this pond for years. Best days of my life catching that fish. Had to use myself as bait. Stuck on me head ever since. Poor little worms. They didn't ask to be here. But how do you fish without them? One for me, one for the fishes. Slurp 'em down. If you need help catching anything, you just ask. The stranger was trapped, caught in a maze. was hard to make sense of this place,